Imagine your belly fat as a terrorist cell inside your body, constantly sending out inflammatory signals that make you gain even more weight. Sounds like science fiction? Well, it's not. This is one of the most important discoveries in metabolism research, and it explains why losing weight gets harder the more you need to lose it. Back in the 1990s, a researcher named Gökhan Hotamisligil made a discovery that changed everything we thought we knew about fat. He found that fat tissue, especially the visceral fat around your organs, doesn't just store energy. It's actually waging an inflammatory war against your metabolism. He called this meta-inflammation. And once you understand how it works, you'll never think about belly fat the same way again. Here's what's happening inside your body right now if you're carrying excess visceral fat. Picture your fat cells as tiny balloons. When you gain weight, these balloons inflate bigger and bigger. But here's the problem. Fat cells aren't meant to stretch indefinitely. When they get too big, they start suffocating. They literally cannot get enough oxygen, and they begin to panic. And when fat cells panic, they do what any distressed cell does. They call for help by releasing chemical alarm signals called cytokines. Think of these as cellular SOS messages flooding through your bloodstream. Your immune system hears these distress calls and sends in the cavalry, immune cells called macrophages. Now, macrophages are normally the good guys, like cellular janitors cleaning up damage. But when they invade your fat tissue, something sinister happens. They get stuck there and transform into inflammatory foot soldiers, constantly pumping out toxic chemicals like TNF-alpha and interleukin-6. Your fat tissue essentially becomes a war zone with chronic inflammation raging 24/7. But here's why it gets really diabolical. These inflammatory chemicals don't just stay in your fat, they travel through your bloodstream like poison, specifically targeting your body's ability to respond to insulin. They literally hack your cellular machinery, blocking insulin from doing its job of controlling blood sugar and fat storage. And when insulin can't work properly, three terrible things happen. First, your body can't control the release of fat from your fat cells, so fatty acids pour into your bloodstream like a broken dam. Second, these fatty acids get deposited in places they don't belong, your liver, your muscles, creating even more inflammation. Third, and this is the cruelest twist, your body responds to this metabolic chaos by storing even more visceral fat, making the problem worse. It's a perfect vicious cycle. More belly fat creates more inflammation, which creates more insulin resistance, which creates more belly fat. Your own fat tissue has essentially hijacked your metabolism. At the molecular level, this is happening through several key pathways that scientists have now mapped out. The inflammatory signals activate stress enzymes with names like JNK and IKK-beta, which then sabotage a crucial protein called IRS1. Think of IRS1 as the key that starts your metabolic engine. When it's damaged, your whole system breaks down. Meanwhile, something called the NLRP3 inflammasome, basically a molecular alarm system, keeps getting triggered by the excess nutrients and cellular debris, maintaining this state of chronic inflammation like a fire that never goes out. But here's the amazing thing about understanding this mechanism. Knowledge is power. Once you know you're fighting a vicious cycle, you can break it. Anti-inflammatory foods, exercise, stress reduction, and strategic weight loss can all help quiet this inflammatory storm. The cycle that makes weight gain accelerate can be reversed. The same pathways that work against you can be turned to work for you. So the next time someone tells you that weight loss is just about willpower, you can tell them the truth. You're not fighting a simple energy equation. You're fighting a sophisticated biological warfare system. But now that you understand the enemy, you're better equipped to win the war.